What's up guys, Tayo here, and the ITS 17 has just been announced, and in this video I'll be telling you all what you need to know about that device. I'll be telling you if you should get it or not. So sit back and relax while you click on that like button for the YouTube algorithm and click on that subscribe button to join the family if you haven't already, because I make awesome tech content like this. And with that being said, okay guys, let's get started. The ITS 17 is made out of plastic, and at this price range which I'll be telling you towards the end of the video, it is very much expected. We get a 6.6 inch IPS LCD display with a resolution of 720 by 1600 pixels, which means it's a 720p display, which will be enough for apps like YouTube, Instagram and the likes. The ITS 17 runs on Android 11 Go Edition, which is a lighter version of Android, which means it runs smoothly on this device. Speaking of processor, we get a Unisoc whatever, I'll display it here, the name is really long, processor, which is an entry level processor for this device, coupled with up to 3GB of RAM and 64GB of storage. Yes, the specifications are low, and you would expect that for this device. So you can do basic tasks like little bit of gaming and social media. If you do anything else, this device won't be able to run it smoothly. We get a triple camera setup consisting of a 8MP main camera, a 2MP macro camera and a depth camera. Videos from the camera maxes out at 1080p 30 frames per second, and also 1080p 30 frames per second from the 8MP selfie camera. The ITS 17 rocks a 5000mAh battery, which will last you well over a day on normal usage, because you won't be doing any intensive tasks on this device. And if it dies on you, you can charge it back from 0 to 100% in 3 hours or even more, using the 5W charger that comes with it in the box. Now, the ITS 17 costs around 60,000 Naira, although take note that the prices of this device might vary based on your location. So yeah, this device is for people who need a secondary device, for your grandparents, or people who wants to give their children their first smartphone. Like if you want to give your children his or her first smartphone, you can give your children this device. But if you don't fall into this category, I would advise you not to get this device. This device isn't worth your money. I would advise you to save a bit more and get a better device like the Infinix or 10i or 10p or something like that, if you want the below 100,000 Naira range. So yeah, let me know your thoughts on this device in the comment section below, and click on that like button if you haven't already, and the subscribe button to join the family as I've said earlier. And with that being said, thanks for watching, and catch you guys in the next video. Peace.